Good morning, all of you. So as we come to know that in last class, we have been studied that what is solubility and how this solubility will be varies for different substances. So what do you mean by solubility? Can anybody say? Last class, you understand correct? So what do you mean by solubility?
Sir, the maximum amount of solute can be dissolved in 100 gram of solvent at a specified temperature is known as solubility.
So, when you can take any kind of given solute, the maximum amount of that given solute can be dissolved in 100 grams of solvent at a specified temperature is known as the solubility of that solute in that given solvent. Is it yes or no, guys? That is what we should call as solubility. So, now, the solubility will change as with based upon the temperature as well as pressure. So, now, if the temperature rises, then what about the solubility? If the pressure rises, what about the solubility? As well as when temperature and pressure will decreases, what about the solubility? Now we will discuss in our today's class. Shall we start now? So, effect of temperature and pressure on solubility. So, if you will observe very, very carefully, first one, the effect of temperature and pressure on solubility. First, if we will take, the solubility of solids in liquids usually increases on increasing the temperature and decreases on decreasing the temperature. What is the graph? First one, the solubility of solid solutes. If you will take, what is that first point? The solubility of whose rock? The solubility of
solid solute.
Solid solutes. What is happening? Solubility increases with increasing temperature. Decreases with decreasing understanding. Decreasing the temperature. Understand, Ra? Maitreyan? So in solid, understand the solubility of solids in liquids. Solid solutes in liquids increases on increasing temperature and what is happening now? Decreases on decreasing temperature. Are you clear, Sai? So, if you take any kind of solid, suppose sugar, a salt, or etc., etc., if you dissolve in water, if you increase the temperature, more salt will dissolve. If you decrease the temperature, less salt will dissolve. That is what the first point you have to understand. So, the solubility of solid in liquids. Understand, Ra, everybody? Sahana. Sorry, Shruti.
Sir.
Yes, that is how to understand. This is the first point. Now, let us come to the second point. If you observe, the solubility of solids in liquids, if you increase the pressure or decrease the pressure, doesn't matter. There is no change in understanding solubility. So, the solids in liquids remains unaffected by the change in pressure. What happened, Ra? Remains unaffected. The solubility of everything is MCQ. The solubility of solids in liquids remains unaffected. What is that, Pradosh? Remains
unaffected.
What do you mean by unaffected? Unaffected.
There are no change.
No pressure. By change in pressure. Means if the pressure increases, if P pressure increases or pressure decreases, doesn't matter. The solubility of solids does not depend on pressure. Do you understand, guys? That is the second point. So here 2 points I have to understand regarding solid solute. What is that? Solids in where?
Solid solutes.
In liquids. So, solids in liquids increases, the solubility increases on increasing temperature and decreases on decreasing temperature. And second one, it is unaffected. The solubility remains same or unaffected by change in pressure. That is we have to understand. Sir, why? The reason I will say, listen. So the solubility of solids, the solids, they have a particular shape, understand? And by change in pressure, there is no further dissolution of solid substances. That is what reason behind, you have to remember. Sir, in case of temperature, what is happening, sir? In case of temperature, particles, the liquid particles are gaining the heat energy. So means in a sense of they are getting the energy. So particles will move far each other because of more kinetic energy. Understanding? Because of continuous heating. So more solid will dissolve. Is it okay, guys? But here, because of increasing pressure or decreasing pressure, no change in energy. So that is why solids cannot dissolve in liquids, unaffected. Okay, Pradosh? Shruti, respond me, please.
Yes, sir.
Call to others. Maitreyan, are you clear? Sai? No. Let us come to the regarding solids is over. Solids in liquids is over. Now, what will come from next one? The solubility of liquids. Is it yes or no? So let us go with the solubility of gases now. So the solubility of gases in liquids usually decreases on increasing temperature and increases on decreasing the temperature. So gases, if you take, what will happen? The solubility of gases opposite to the solids. If you increase the temperature, solubility will decrease. If you decrease the temperature, solubility will increase. That is what you have to remember. Right? The solubility of gases. The solubility of gases decreases on. Decreases on increasing temperature. Increasing temperature and increases on decreasing temperature. Are you clear, guys? Sai, opposite gases, the solubility of gases decreases. Gases in liquids decreases on increasing temperature and increases on decreasing temperature. That is opposite to solid solute. Next, what it is, pressure. Can you say the pressure effect? Gases does not have any particular shape. So pressure increases, they will compress. So pressure decreases, they will again expand. So that is what. So the solubility of gases in liquids increases on increasing the pressure and decreases on decreasing the pressure. Do you understand, Ra? Yes or no, guys? Tell me out, please. Nobody's answering.
Yes, sir.
Gases in liquids increases on increasing the pressure and decreases on decreasing the pressure. That is the fourth point. Write it. The solubility of gases gases in liquids increases on increasing pressure. Increasing pressure and decreasing pressure. Did you okay? All of you respond. Yes or no? Shruti, Alana, so this is the four points. Now we will solve. We will describe the effect of temperature and solubility of a solid substance in water in a little more in detail. So let us take one solid solute and it is dissolving at a particular given temperature. What is the dissolution of solubility in water at a given temperature? We'll take it. Now, let us take the temperature reading 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70 degrees. Till 70 degrees, we'll take it. And I will take one solid solute called as copper sulfate. Okay, all of you? So now, I am going to take example of solid in liquid, solid in liquid. And what I am doing, Ra? Increasing temperature. What I am doing? Increasing temperature. Respond, yeah. Increasing temperature. So now, if temperature is increasing, solubility is increases or decreases? Solid, solid. First point. You read first point. What is that? The solubility of solute in liquids increases on increasing temperature and decreases on decreasing temperature. Is it yes or no? That is what we are going to.
Yes, sir.
So I am taking one solid solute. Solid solute is, let me take copper sulfate solute. What is that, Ra? Copper sulfate. Understanding, copper sulfate is solid. And what is the liquid, Ra? Can you able to say what is the liquid? Liquid is what? Solute, Ra?
Water.
Water. So this is the solvent. Sorry. This is the solvent and this is the solute. Now, let us take how the copper sulfate experimentally proved this one. How much it is dissolved for a given temperature reading. So first one, let me take the temperature and solubility of copper sulfate. Copper sulfate formula is what? CuSO4. Understand? So now, let us take the different temperatures. 0 degree Celsius, 10 degree Celsius, 20 degree Celsius, 30 degree Celsius, 40 degree Celsius, 50 degree Celsius, 60 degree Celsius, 70 degree Celsius. So what is the temperature? Is it increasing or decreasing, Ra? Respond, yeah.
Increasing, sir.
Now, so if you take a 0 degree Celsius, like almost like a solid state of water, understand? So if you keep the copper sulfate in that, we can dissolve 14 grams of copper sulfate. How much we can dissolve, Ra? 14 grams of copper sulfate.
14 grams of copper sulfate.
Temperature increases to 10 degree Celsius, then the copper sulfate we can dissolve is 17 grams. Like that, 20 degree Celsius means 21 grams we can. Next 30 means 24 grams. Next 40 means 29 grams. Next 50 means 34 grams. Next 60 means 40 grams. 60 means 40 grams. 70 means 47 grams. What is that, Ra? 47 grams. Understand, Ra, guys? Now, observe very carefully here. What are you observing? Anybody can say? What are you observing? Temperature is keep on rising. Sai, what is happening, Ra? The amount of copper sulfate dissolving in water is also keep on increasing. Is it yes or no? Now, if we'll take reverse, if the temperature is keep on decreasing, then the amount of solubility is also decreasing. Is it yes, guys? Yes or no? Respond me. So that is the example. See,
yes, sir.
Temperature is 0 degree Celsius, the copper sulfate dissolving in water is 14 grams. Next, temperature become 10, 17 grams. Next, temperature become 20, 21, 30, 24. Like that, when the temperature becomes 70, 47 grams is dissolving. So that is what you have to remember. So, while the temperature is keep on increasing, the solubility of solid solute, is increases on increasing temperature and decreases on decreasing temperature. That is what you have to remember. So if you observe in this figure, in these values, at the 0 degree Celsius, the solubility of solid solute is 14 grams. At 70 degrees, how much, Ra? At 70 degrees, how much? At 70 degrees, how much?
47 grams, sir.
7 grams. Correct or not? So, now, let us see what will happen when we cool a saturated solution of copper sulfate from a higher temperature to a lower temperature. Now, my copper sulfate solution is in 70 degrees Celsius. So, that how much it is dissolving? How much it is maximum dissolving, Ra? Anybody? How much it is dissolving? 47 grams. So now if you will take the copper sulfate solution, is it saturated or unsaturated? Continuously it is increasing. So at 70 degrees, what is there? Copper sulfate solution at 70 degrees. At 70 degrees if we'll take, so maximum 47 grams is dissolving. Maximum 47. So at this temperature, no more solute is dissolved. So this is only called as what? At this situation, what we should call this one? Saturated solution. What
saturated solution.
saturated solution. So no more further solute is dissolved at a given temperature is called as saturated solution. Now, the what is the temperature of saturated solution, Ra? What is the temperature of saturated solution? 70 degrees Celsius. Now, I have taken a beaker and inside water and copper sulfate solution. This is called as copper sulfate solution. What we should call? Copper sulfate solution. So now that is also called as saturated solution. So now continuously I have been heated. So the temperature is, which is equals to 70 degrees Celsius. Now, suddenly if I'll start cooling to the lower temperatures, what will happen? We are going to see now. So observe very carefully. At room temperature means basically 20 degrees Celsius you can consider. Now, suddenly you can start cooling. Suddenly cooling, then what is going to happen to this saturated solution? We are going to discuss now. So now, observe very carefully, you will see the solubility of copper sulfate at 70 degrees Celsius is 47 grams and the solubility of copper sulfate at 20 degrees. 20 degrees is how much? Observe carefully and tell me. At 20 degrees how much? At 20 degrees.
21 grams.
Is it yes or no? So this is what our normal room temperature basically according to chemistry. Now till now we are considering that only, but naturally now it is increased. But you remember. So at 20 degrees Celsius the solubility is 21 grams and 70 degrees Celsius 47 grams. Now if I will start cooling from 47 to 20 degrees, what guys will happen? Can you enable to say? Now temperature falls. Temperature decreases from 70 degrees to 20 degrees Celsius. What is going to happen to the solubility of solute? Can you able to say?
Solubility decreases to 21 gram.
Yes, that is not already dissolved solid. What will happen to that? It will be condenses back or not? Temperature will fall. So again, it will form or not? Nobody is saying. So observe very carefully. 70 degrees Celsius, it is 47 grams. And the solubility of copper sulfate at 20 degrees Celsius is 21 grams. Now, if you observe, the 100 grams of water at the 70 degrees Celsius means in the sense of what is the solubility? Can you able to say? 100 grams of water can dissolve. What is the maximum amount of salt, Ra? What is the maximum amount of salt?
36 grams.
At 100 degrees, 70 degrees Celsius, man. How much it is maximum dissolved? 47
grams.
So what do you mean by solubility? For how much amount of water? For how much amount of water we will take? Always we will take for 100
grams of water.
Yes or no? So for 100 grams of water. So observe very carefully at 70 degrees Celsius, at 20 degrees Celsius. So at 70 degrees Celsius, maximum amount of solubility of a copper sulfate is 47 grams. 47 grams in how much amount of solute? In 100 grams of water.
100 grams of water.
Is 100 grams of water. Like same way, at 20 degrees Celsius, maximum how much, Ra? 21 grams in. How much amount of water? 100 grams of water. Do you understand, guys? So, this is called as solubility. This is only we should call it as solubility. Is it yes or no?
Yes.
Now,
sir.
My question is, if the temperature will fall, if we'll start cooling the saturated solution of copper sulfate made in 100 grams of water from 70 degrees to 20 degrees Celsius, then as we know that my friend just now said, the solubility of copper sulfate will decrease. Is it yes or no? Solubility of solid will decreases. Is it yes, guys? Now, I am going to reduce the temperature from 70 degrees to how much it will become, Ra? 20 degrees. Is it yes or no? So, same way if you observe, temperature is false. How much temperature is false, Ra? 70 minus 20 degrees. What is the change in temperature? Change in temperature is how much? Decrease in temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. So the temperature falls to 50 degrees Celsius, falls to less than, understanding, minus 50, which is equals to 20 degrees Celsius. Now same way, what is the solubility? How much it is decreases? 747 grams to 21 grams, which is equals how much? Can you able to do subtraction? 50 degrees decreases. 50 degrees decrease, so that this is how much, 47 minus 21, which is equal to how much, Sai?
26, sir.
26 grams of solid copper sulfate. What will happen? It will be reformed into crystals. Is it yes or no, guys? So at 20 degrees,
sir,
grams, at the 47 grams, so the temperature keep on decreasing, then 26 grams of copper sulfate crystals, copper sulfate will form crystals. What it will form? Crystals in a given solution. Do you understand, Ra?
Yes, sir.
Solution, that is what, because at 20 degrees Celsius 100 grams of water cannot hold more than 21 degrees 21 grams. Is it yes or no? So remaining salt, remaining copper sulfate will form a solid crystals. Is it okay, guys? So temperature decreases, then the copper sulfate cannot hold maximum in the water, 100 grams of water. So only 21 grams will be dissolving in water, 100 grams of water, remaining copper sulfate will converting into water, solid crystals. What is that? At 20 degrees Celsius, only 21 grams remaining in soluble, remaining, what is happening, Ra? It will form water. It will form solid crystals. Understand, Ra? So at the bottom, it will form solid crystals. Crystals of what, Ra? Crystals of CuSO4, copper sulfate crystals. That is how to understand. Understanding, Ra? Everybody? Dharun? Yes or no? That is. Be very careful. Now, let me see my train or anybody. You all respond. Suppose if the temperature will falls to 70 to 10 degrees, then how much solid crystals will form bottom? Anybody can say? Sai? Now 70 degrees to 10 degrees it will form. Means almost 60 degrees temperature is decreases. So at 70 degrees means 47 grams. At 10 degrees means how much solubility? How much 10 degrees? 10 degrees means
17, sir.
17 degrees, 17 grams. So now, how much solid will form? If the degree
30 grams of copper sulfate.
Yeah, 17 grams. So 47 minus 17, 0, 30. So 30 grams of solid, understanding, solid CuSO4 crystals will form. Is it okay, guys? Do you understand all of you this concept? Yes or no? Respond me.
Sir.
Yeah. That is what you have to understand. Are you clear? I hope. Yes. Now, let us solve a problem based upon this. You guys can understand it. Now, can you solve the problem? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you'll observe very carefully, if you'll solve the problem, then you guys can easily understand more nicely. So let us go with the problem. All of you try to understand this problem. If you're able to understand this problem, you can able to solve this very easily. So now, observe very carefully. This is the sample problem one. All of you read this sample problem. Very, very important sample problem. If you'll read this, you can understand everything very carefully. All of you read. Observe very carefully. Here I am making temperatures are varies. Here I observe very this one. Okay. See, this is 10 degrees. Sorry. It is coming like this. I will match it. See, this is exactly it is. I am trying to match. So all of you read the question. Pradosh. See, 21.
A student determined the solubility of four substances, potassium nitrate, sodium chloride, potassium chloride and ammonium chloride in water at 5 different temperatures of 10 degrees Celsius, 20 degrees Celsius, 40 degrees Celsius, 60 degree Celsius and 80 degree Celsius and obtained the following data.
Yes, now see, I am arranging the data also according to that you follow. Okay, now read first first data, note down the question first, all of you. Very, very important, Samra. Based upon this, so many MCQs will come. Sorry. Sai, read the question. Now let me see who will find first. So what they are asking, can you able to say? So they are saying that, what is they are saying? A student determined the solubility of four substances. One is, first one is water, potassium nitrate. Second one is sodium chloride. And third one is potassium chloride. And the next one is ammonium chloride in water at different, five different temperatures. What is the temperatures? 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 40 degrees, 60 degrees and 80 degrees. And obtain the following data. Solubility, substances solubility. So potassium nitrate at 10 degrees. 10 degrees how much? 10 degrees how much it is? 10 degrees how much? Nobody is saying. Potassium nitrate at 10 degrees, 21 grams. Understand? Next, 20 degrees. 20 degrees how much? 20 degrees how much? What I say?
32 grams.
20 degrees, 32 grams, 40, 62, and 60, 106, and 80, 167. So like this, remember this. Now they are asking, what mass of potassium nitrate would be needed to make a saturated solution of potassium nitrate in 50 grams of water at 40 degrees Celsius, they are asking. 50 grams. So basically, this is all for how many grams, Ra? This is all for how many grams of water? Anybody can say? These are all the solutions we have been prepared for 100 grams. Is it yes or no, guys? 100
grams of water. Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
100 grams of water, because solubility we can find for 100 grams only, correct or not? Now they are asking for 50 grams, for 50 grams at 40 degrees Celsius. What is the compound? Potassium nitrate, 40 degrees Celsius, only 50 grams of water I am taking. So how much solute is needed, they are asking. So can you able to say how much potassium nitrate is dissolved? First question, observe very carefully. What mass of potassium nitrate? First question, what mass of potassium nitrate? Potassium nitrate, Maitreyan, you answer. Potassium nitrate would be needed to make a saturated solution of potassium nitrate solution. Potassium nitrate in 50 grams of water, not 100 grams, half. Half only I am taking. So how much amount of solute? Solute is how much? The solvent. Solvent which is equals to 50 grams. That is what we can say water. So if 100 grams, which is equals to how much? At 100 grams of water, how much? 40 degrees, 62 degrees. Is it yes or no, guys? 62 grams it is dissolving. Now, if 100 become 50, 1 minute, let me write it clearly. So solvent at 40 degrees, which is equals to how much? 100 grams. And what is the dissolution solute? Solute is how much? Ra, at 100 degrees Celsius, 100 grams of solvent, how much?
2 grams,
potassium nitrate, 62 grams. Is it yes or no? 62 grams we can dissolve. Now they are asking, if solvent decreases to 50 grams, then what about this solute, they are asking. So can you able to find it? Temperature is constant. Can anybody find it? Answer, please. Answer. Half is, a solvent will become half. Solute also will become what? Solute also will become half. That's all. Then why are you wasting time? You can answer correct. So, solvent become 100 grams, become 50 sir. Grams. Then we can say, this is half. That's all. So it is also become half only. So you can observe here, 100 become 50 means in the sense of 100 by 2, it is becoming half, which is equals to 50 gram. So here also, solute also will become what? 62 by 2, which is equals how many grams? 31 grams. So if we'll take 50 grams of solvent at same 40 degrees Celsius, so how much potassium nitrate will dissolve? extra 31 grams of potassium nitrate will be dissolved. Are you clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? That is okay, Maitreya. Next, second one. All of you read. You have to read. Shruti, you answer. Shruti, what happened to you? Sai, you also. Darun, respond here. Now, what would be observed if a saturated solution of potassium chloride? Potassium chloride means what? Second question. Is it yes or no? Second data.
Yes, sir.
Potassium chloride at 80 degree Celsius. 80 degree Celsius. 80 degree Celsius. 80 degree Celsius, how much it is there? How much it is there? 80 degree Celsius.
4.
Ray, 80 degree Celsius, ra. Potassium chloride. Oh, sorry, sir.
Third.
Okay. Potassium chloride, third one. Third one, correct? So, third one.
Yes, sir.
It equals to how much, ra? 54 grams. And I am leaving it for cooling. I am leaving it to the cooling. Cooling in the sense of what? Left to cool to the room temperature. So, room temperature means how much I set you to consider? What is the room temperature I set you to consider? Room temperature means how much, ra? Basically, degrees. 30 or 20, you can take it. Whatever it is. They are not mentioning particular temperature. So, what will happen, they are asking. So, when a saturated solution of potassium chloride at 80 degrees is left to cool, then what will happen? What will happen to us? We will observe what? Already we have seen at here. Up we have seen. What is forming? Copper sulfate crystals is
forming. Copper sulfate crystals, sir.
So same way here, if we reduce the temperature, what will happen? What would be observed? What you will observe? So if you leave it for the potassium, understanding, from 80 degrees to room temperature,
30 degrees
temperature, whatever it is, room temperature, what we can find, ra? The solid crystals will form. Is it yes or no? So a solid,
yes, sir.
Chloride, a solid potassium chloride crystals will form at the bottom. Do you understand? That is what we will observe. So solid potassium chloride so potassium chloride crystals will form. Is it okay, ra? Will be formed. Sai, understand? That is, we are going to observe it. Now, third question answer. Alana, answer the third question. You have to answer the third question. What is the third question? Read, all of you. What is the solubility of each salt at 20 degrees Celsius?
Which salt has the highest solubility at this temperature?
So go and observe the table and tell me. You have to tell me, I won't say. What is the solubility? Everybody can say solubility of various salts at 20 degrees Celsius. First, potassium nitrate. How much, ra? Alana, respond me. Shruti, you also, Sai. Just a very simple question.
This is ammonium chloride only, sir.
So potassium nitrate at 20 degrees Celsius. Observe very carefully. 20 degrees Celsius, how much it is? 32 grams. Sodium chloride, 36 grams. Potassium chloride, 35 grams. Ammonium chloride, sir. So, which is dissolving maximum at 20 degrees Celsius?
Ammonium chloride.
37 grams. So, that is ammonium chloride. Write it. Answer. So, what is the solubility of each salt? That values you should write. Which salt has the highest solubility in temperature? What is that?
Ammonium chloride, sir.
Ammonium chloride. Right. Next. What is the effect of change of temperature? What is the effect of change of temperature on the solubility of salt as shown by the above data? Effect of temperature. Temperature is increasing. What is happening? You have to tell me. Temperature is increasing. So what is happening? Effect of solubility. Increases or decreases?
Also increases, sir.
That is what you have to say. That is the last point. Write it. The solubility of salt increases on increasing the temperature. Fourth question. The solubility of salt increases. What is happening? Increases with increasing temperature. Increasing temperature. Please all of you note it down. Very, very important question. So like this, they will ask you in exam also, Pradosh. Phi, understand? So many things. This is what about the solubility. So pressure increases, solid solubility decreases, remains unaffected, but gases, pressure increases, solubility increases, pressure decreases, solubility decreases. Temperature, gases temperature increases, solubility decreases, gases temperature decreases, solubility will increases. Is it yes or no, guys? That is what you have to remember it. So now, if you understand this one, I hope you all understand very clearly. Any doubt, Ra? Yes or no? Now, we are going to entering into the last concept of this chapters. This is what the most important. I think you already studied in our already normal classes. That is separation of mixtures. Like what we are using, like a separation of, by using filtration, by using something chromatography, distillation, like that you have been studied. Is it yes? Have you studied already? That is study. So that is what very, very important. So now the last concept we'll study is, first we'll study what is the physical and chemical changes. After that, we'll go for separation techniques. We'll finish this chapter. I think this is only for our PT2. Is it yes, guys? Yes, that is.
Sir.
Now observe very carefully. Solids in liquids. Solids in liquids. What we can make? Solids in liquids. Increasing temperature, solubility increases. Understand, Ra? Solubility increases. Sir. Increasing temperature.